Hi there, welcome back. If you've not been here before, I'm Michael. Hello. I'm a graphic designer and creative director. And I just wanted to expand upon one of the projects I showed you in my last video, which highlighted several projects. But now I just wanted to take one of those and extrapolate on that and show you what we presented for the full extent of that project. And the project is, as you can see, Titanic Belfast. So let's dive in and I'll explain more as we go along. So we were brought in by Kay Elliott to work on the project at Reba stages D, E and F. Basically that means being involved as part of the concept design, the design development and then the technical design. I'll go through the Reba stages another time, just to explain that. They're a construct that helps to develop architectural projects. So this document is Connected Thinking. It was presented to the client and the main investors of Titanic Quarter, the whole island on which the museum was a small part. This document outlines our vision for adding coherence to the master plan, charting the user journey from people discovering information about the museum to experiencing the building and exploring the Titanic Quarter beyond. So we're going to run through quite quickly, but you can scrub through at any point and have a look at it, really interrogate it, let me know what you want to learn. Any questions, give me a shout. Okay, let's dive in. So we outlined the guiding principles of the information journey. Using storytelling as extended marketing through audio recordings. Publishing profiles with stories of lost relatives to be discovered by people researching their own family histories. And to commission a Google Earth tour telling Titanic's story in reverse, thereby leading back to Belfast. We also demonstrated that the whole of the Titanic Quarter was pedestrian friendly, to way beyond the confines of the museum, and stressed the importance of maintaining accessibility for all visitors throughout. We achieved this by breaking down the Titanic Quarter into a series of 5-minute walks, thereby establishing districts, for example, the Dry Dock, West Wharf or East Mooring, instantly creating neighbourhoods. And to really press the point of using a universal visual language across the entire area in the museum and beyond, rather than having competing systems, we suggested the installation of these monolithic hull-like splices as exterior wayfinding at key locations, and creating additional geolocated audio tours, taking the museum into the surrounding area. Landmarks would then be plotted and routes established to create theme tours. Adding street name signage and district name murals to key neighborhood boundaries. Inlaying compasses on key street corners to assist orientation, and street furniture to rest weary feet, and also to adopt AR to create an overlay street museum like the one pioneered by the Museum of London. We also suggested painting murals on gables, which is synonymous with Belfast, conveying the history of key businesses or significant individuals. So now on to the museum itself. This diagram illustrates the design system applied to the museum building, with 2 floors of parking below sea level, and as the branding evolves, upwards through the building, becoming lighter and more refined through the use of colour and typography to reflect the varying classes of the ship itself. We suggested inlaying brass components into the paving as though dropped in the shipyard, and also to introduce individual stories to build empathy in the windows. We created surface graphics charting the inventory loaded onto the ship that ran across four floors of the main atrium, and a life-size elevation as a blueprint to span five floors on the opposing wall. Four retail units on the ground floor also had to fit the look and feel and sit well coherently in the space. The identities, which you may have already seen, are now shown in colour. This is for the hospitality suite of the top two floors of the building, which we then applied to marketing materials for its private hire. And then there was the core wayfinding system to navigate the entire building. To achieve this, whilst the building was still being constructed, we quickly modelled the entire building in the gaming engine Unity and used it to determine circulation, clear lines of sight, accessibility, safety, and lighting. We're going to fly through the technicals quite quickly now. So here we had to specify materials and colours, the stacked box system and its variations, of which there's a few slides here. And then we had the wall-mounted stacks. And again, a few variations of the technical drawings. These were handed to the manufacturer. And the backlit lift safety wayfinding system. Again, just technical drawings for their manufacturer, along with information and ticketing kiosks. And last but not least, because first impressions last, the uniforms developed with field grey for the museum and restaurant staff. So, it's turning out to be a glorious day here in Sheffield, but as you would have seen from that, there's quite a lot of detail in there. And a great project to work on because it was kind of open-ended. We could just present anything that we thought would help the messaging, the story, the architecture. So I hope you enjoyed that. Please, again, do look at that in detail, scrub through, back and forth, have a look at where your knowledge gaps are and what, if anything, within this presentation you would like to know more about. Please do subscribe, please share, and I'll be back very soon. Cheers.